Hey guys, it's Max Kvesty. How's everyone doing? Better than me, probably. I've just been doing this report for 10 minutes, talking to no one. I thought I was live. Oh my gosh. All right. Let's look at these defiance funds. I have the profit boxes drawn for tomorrow. They got a gigantic amount of premium. Look at Triple QI. They sold the 17,600 strike, but they got 141 bucks, which isn't as much as 2 days ago. But still, look at how much extrinsic premium they captured. That's a gigantic amount of extrinsic. And look what their dividend is running on the month. So right now, it's running $1.01. I always say don't go buy this because of me, because you see this or whatever. But I really was serious about that because it was like the day before Declaration Day, whenever I was making the prediction. But early in the month, if you see something you like developing early in the month, yeah, this might be a good time if you wanted to get some more of this anyway. Because it looks like this may be a good month for this fund, or it started out that way. And it's not just this fund. Look at the dividend prediction on JEPY, 88 cents. I mean, where they paid 78 cents last time, and IWMY is like $1.29 right now. It's crazy. All right, well, these guys sold the 2025 strike 769 times. I'm sorry, they're going for a max profit of 1.4 million. They got $19, which is a ton of premium. Not as much as 2 days ago, but it was a ton of premium. And then what other one had one looked at? We looked at all. Okay, this is the last one we haven't looked at. JEPY, they sold the 5075 strike for 30 bucks. Okay, well, they received a lot of extrinsic, more extrinsic than they've received in a month or so. So in any event, it's starting off to be a big month for premium collection, because it's one day vol. The market vol isn't too elevated. It's the one day vol. In any event, okay, well, let's look at something more fun. This isn't very fun. Let's look at some profit boxes. And then, first of all, let's look at futures market. Here's a 24-hour futures chart. I'm going to turn on my special indicator, my 24-hour indicator. This has an algorithm that shows you where the market's going. It's going to there. It's always right, too. This thing's never wrong. Obviously, I'm joking, but I really like how you can, this 24-hour futures charts, these are half-hour bars. And if you haven't seen these before, they change colors as the day changes. So this red is London, and they put a box around the London range, okay? Then the purple is the New York session, and they put the purple box around the New York range. So the lows were the same, New York and London, but the high was higher. In any event, so that was the New York, and then in green is Asia. And here's the green, here's Asian last night. So it goes Asian into, you know, so next is coming up the London Open. All right, in any event, I think we close on the highs of the week and the day tomorrow. Just a guess. That's just a guess. All right, so let's look at some other stuff. Let me show you this profit box here for Triple QI. It doesn't look as big on the chart as it does on the spreadsheet, but I mean, it is. I drew it to the right scale and stuff. I mean, that's a gigantic amount of yellow there for the extrinsic yellow, because extrinsic is good as gold. And green is intrinsic, because intrinsic's like money or in the money. So that's the way I remember it. Green is intrinsic, and the yellow part of the box is the extrinsic of the time. All right, so You want to look at some profit or not profit boxes? We can, we're looking at profit boxes right now. That was a crazy whipsaw at the end of yesterday, or the day before yesterday, I guess now. That was a crazy whipsaw. Should have been full profit on all these funds, and the profit was huge. But I mean, this fund still salvaged. The Russell still salvaged about half a profit there, or a little bit more than half a profit. All right, how about the Buffer Report? How's that sound? Let me see what chart we want to start with. All right, so here we have single names. So this is kind of boring compared to how it has been lately, but oh, that's 1 month. I was going to say, there's no way that's a single day. All right, 1 day, single name. Yes, there we go, of course. Look at this, NVIDIA killing it, Coney killing it, Misty killing it, AMSI, Apley, everybody up. Zomo, I never can say that. Zomo, only one on the chart that's down. That's the ultimate boomer stock. There was back in April when everything else was doing bad, that one was doing well. You know, boy, that's a good looking chart right there. No real outperformance, but Sky came close, right? It did. So, there we go. This is what I was looking at. All right. So the indexes were up huge, more than a point. You can see right there. Red is that. Well, that one's Russell. Russell was up 181 basis points. Triple Qs were up 129 basis points. And SPY was up a little bit less than a point. All right. 100 basis points, or a little bit less than one percentage point. All right. So they all underperformed, or mostly they did. And because when the indexes are up that much, a cover calls sacrificing upside. So they're going to have problems on days like today, keeping up with the index. Okay. Having said that, though, there's a few of them that did really well, like YMAX and ULTY outperformed, and also YMAG outperformed. And also NUSI outperformed. And I think yesterday it underperformed. I mean, it had a really bad day yesterday, so it made up for it today. Tuggin, I don't think Tuggin had a great day yesterday either. But in any event, those look good. Okay, so let's go out a little bit further. And then I'll take a question or two if you guys. Okay, I was so stupid to do it this way, but this chart. The benchmark is in blue, which is on the left-hand side. I have a hardest time thinking about that, but benchmark blue makes sense, but I'm used to looking at the left side for the yield stock and the right side for the, it's fine though. All right, so I want to look for, I can't even hardly do this. Okay, well, over the course of a month, ULTY is underperformed on the, QDTE. Those are the big standout underperformers. And even SPY-T over the course of a month. Just a percentage point, but outperformed that. But, I mean, it was bad for everything. I mean, nothing's good. I mean, I know SPY-T, it's one of my favorite funds. Everyone's entitled to a bad month. Look at old JetQ. JetQ did a really nice job. That's parent was down 4, it was down 3. That's a 25% difference. 25%, that's a gigantic buffer. Trying to get comfortable here. Anyway, SPY-T did not exhibit the buffer. JetBuy had some pretty nice buffer. Look at that. QQQY outperformed. Oh, on the way down though. Oops. Yeah. SPY-T outperforming on the way down. For the over the course of a month, it was a bad month for Defiance. It was a great week for them last week, but I didn't realize it was such a bad month. IWMY had Buffer. It was only one of them that didn't go down as far as the parent during April. So yeah, that's I didn't actually realize that. Anyway, it's good to look at this stuff together. I need to look at that stuff closer. I know that I gave IWMY the fund of the week last week, and because it was on fire. But that was last week. It had, you know, it obviously hasn't been for 30 days. Maybe it just bounced back so hard last week. Let's look at the chart of that thing. Oh, here it is. Or here, you know, yeah, here's IWMY. So I say this every day. It's either full profit on the upside or a big loss. You know, look how big that profit box was there. Because as the market goes down, volatility goes up. The extrinsic was getting pretty skinny right there. Then the extrinsic capture got huge. Then it got gigantic there, and they got full profit. They captured all that extrinsic plus all that intrinsic. They captured the extrinsic every time. That's why it's gold, and that's why it's so important. The extrinsic always goes to zero. So like on this day, look at this. On this day, as the day starts off and as the day is going on, the value of this box shrinks and shrinks and shrinks and shrinks until it's zero. And extrinsic always goes to zero. It has to be worth zero. Time premium has to be worth zero by the end of the day. All right. It may have been a better demonstration to say it goes to zero like this, but it goes away. It goes away as time passes. Okay. Yeah, so that was a hell of a month for IWMY. All right, so here's the single stocks, and same thing. The benchmark is blue. Okay, that's fine, though. So I'm going to look for a standout bad performance, and I'm seeing one by ULTY. So the rest of the performances, Fibby did not look great either, but the rest of the performances are what you would expect. Some pretty good buffer, even Misty that had a really rough time of it, you know, caught about 33% less downside than the parent. So that's great. Amdi caught 20% less downside than the parent. Let's see if we have any good news. In the good news department, TSLP outperformed over the course of a month. I should have made TSLP the fund of the month. Now that I'm thinking about it, I mean, that's impressive. Especially considering what it's been through. But I'm really starting to take a liking to the Curve guys, Howard and those guys over there at Curve. But I like all these guys. These guys are option jockeys and option nerds. This freaking crash trade is a great trade. It's a four-legged monster. I'm producing some content on it. The video should be out soon, but that trade's a monster. Anyway, that fund's going to have its drawbacks for sure. All right, well, let's see what you guys had to say, if anything. You guys are talkative tonight. You guys aren't too talkative tonight. That's fine. That is fine and dandy. I'm going to look over here at the daily. We're going to look at some daily charts, and then I'll let you guys go. Oh, one more thing. I'm going to make yield match predictions. I almost forgot. I know they do it tomorrow at 7, and they announce at 7:30, but I've been trying a new system on predicting. And I'm not trying to get clicks. I'm not even going to make a separate video. I just want to have a record in case I get these all right. So I just want to have a record somewhere. But plus, I thought maybe guys might be interested in it. I'm concerned about my NVIDIA pick, though. I'm only going with the dollar. I have a mechanical system that tells me what they're going to get. I'm only going with the dollar because that's what the system says to do. And they paid like $260 last time. I mean, I don't think I like my, I don't know if my system's very good. It's kind of like a test system. It's kind of like my system, my earnings trade system, Max's two-step. I mean, it's an interesting system that I'm testing, but I'm not, still not 100% sure on it. Let's look at that real quick. I figure maybe you guys might be interested in that. I was just checking my Discord, hoping that Corey got back with me, but she hasn't. Yeah, that's fine. She's a busy girl. She's a busy girl. Okay. I need to get off this. All right, let's do this real quick. Do this real quick. We'll look at the markets one more time, and then I'll let you go. Gosh darn it. Where is the window I had open? I was just doing it a second ago. Oh, you got to be kidding me. Every time something messes up. Every time. I think I closed it by accident. There it is. Your Max Algo open. My guess is last month, I was not happy with them. I didn't think they were too close at all, but some of them were right on the money though. So, but then I refined my algorithm or my, it's more of a methodology. Pun, an algorithm would be generous. Okay, so here we have my predictions. Let's go. My predictions are in red. I made it red so it's easier to see. Okay, so last month is right here. And this month is right here. All right. Tesla, 75 cents. NVIDIA, $1. I mean, my system, you know, I have no idea. I have no idea. We'll see. We'll see. I think they're going to pay more than that, but that's what the system says. In any event, Kony, $1.90. Misty, $2.60. AMD, 80 cents. AMZ, 70 cents. Infly, $1. Murney, $1.20. Fibby, 95 cents. Dizzo, 55 cents. Zomo, 40 cents. MSFO, 50 cents. Aptly, 35 cents. PayPay, $1.05. GUI, 80 cents. JPMO, 65 cents. OARC, 50 cents. Sky, $1.40. AIYY, 70 cents. There you have it. Those are my predictions. Yeah, but I don't know about that. I don't like my own Kony prediction. Like I say, we're testing the system. So we'll see. I'm thinking about coming on tomorrow and doing a live stream tomorrow morning when they get announced. I don't know. Maybe some of you guys will be there if I do it. Maybe hopefully some of you guys will be there with me. Looks like I have a comment here, which is nice. Thanks for leaving a comment, whoever did that. All right. Yeah, okay. Hey, David, I appreciate the question. That's a great question. Thank you for asking that. They aren't better or worse. Let me, you're kind of new to the channel. And let me try to see if I can explain it. But they aren't, it's not really better or worse is the way to think of it. It's just the total option, let's say the option costs $10, okay? And they sell that option for $10, okay? Well, the option that they sell was 5 points in the money. So it has 5 points of in the money value, which is intrinsic, and then 5 points of out of the money value, which is extrinsic. Okay. In any event, it's just option nerd talk. The whole idea is the whole 10 points, you hope the whole 10 points is going to go to zero. When you're selling a put, you want the market to go up. So here's the profit box. So if the market tomorrow, when it trades, if it finishes at the top line of the profit box or above, it's a full profit. It's a full profit for the system. So they sell these options for 10 and they're worth zero tomorrow. Well, the only thing is the only reason we keep it for different purposes. So you can always tell where the usually the profit box. Hang on a second. I drew this one wrong because I was zoomed out too much. The gold, the extrinsic goes from the bottom of the box, wherever that is, to yesterday's close because they make this trade on the close. So just to make the math easy, or we'll do the real math here because this isn't, they sold the 2025 strike. That's why 2025 is the top line. Okay, so the person that bought the 2025 put from them is betting the market goes below 2025. So they sold the option to them. So they just want the market to be above 2025. All right. Well, so I'm trying to think. Okay, so the 2025 strike, and they sold it, and you can tell this profit box happens to be 20 points. It looks like they sold this option for 20 points, right? Because it goes down to 2005. Okay, so then the line just goes to wherever yesterday's close was. So in this case, it goes to 216 to 225. This example has 9 points of intrinsic and it has 11 points of extrinsic. The only thing that you know about this trade is the extrinsic for sure will be worth zero tomorrow. At the end of the day tomorrow. Even if the market goes straight sideways from yesterday's close, if the market theoretically goes nowhere, they won't have any time value left. This box will shrink. The option will still be worth this much, the in the money amount. But in any event, the only reason we really, it's not really that important. Like I say, you're just trying to, it's one of the many things you look at. The reason we keep track of it is because the way these guys pay the distributions is they just add up all the extrinsic they capture during the month. So they add up all of these yellow boxes, and that's what makes the dividend. Okay. Now the green boxes, sometimes they make money from the green boxes too. And when they do make money from the green boxes, it goes to the NAV or it comes out of the NAV if they lose money from the green boxes. But the yellow boxes, they always make a little bit of money from, and they pay that out as a dividend. So it's just accounting though. It's really all the same difference. There's people that have traded options all their life that don't know the difference between intrinsic and extrinsic. It's not that big of a deal, really. It's just option nerd talk. But anyway, thanks for joining the channel, David. You asked some questions last night. I appreciate it. Yes, I have a yes. I tried to record like five times today. Anyway, I'm going to record it as soon as I get done. It'll be up within an hour. Yeah, it's a great video. I have the slides. I can even show you the slides. They aren't up here anymore. But yeah, I did do a, and it's not a great video, but it's a pretty good video. And it's not like the super long rambly one. It's about 15 minutes, but I get into option strat and I talk about some things and I make some predictions. I think you'll like it. In fact, I'm going to probably kind of cut this short and get out of here and make that one. I've been trying to shoot that one all day. And every time something's wrong, and I'm not doing anything stupid, nothing stupid, like I'm forgetting to put the screen on or something. I don't do that anymore. But just like I'll get to the end of it and then I'll realize I should have added something, or then I'll want to do it a little different. So in any event, I will do it as soon as we get done with this one. I appreciate you for asking though. What's going on, Michael? How you doing there? Philippines tonight. Max never sleeps. Yeah, I do. I take a nap every day. I'm a big napper. But no, I sleep every night from about 1 until about 8. I usually wake up every morning about 8. And then, but usually I, lots of days, I go back to sleep at 3 when the market closes and lay down until about 5. All right. If the market, okay, so David, okay, if the market falls in the white zone, then we lose money. Yes. Okay. So yes, let's go on with the story here. So we sold this option for 11 points. It's the 225 strike. Or 10 points or 20 points. Because, and then the reason this box is 20 points long is because 225 minus 20 is 2005, right? Yes. So the market goes up, the market goes down, market goes up. If at the end of the day it closes in the white above the box on the top side, it's a full profit. Okay. Now you don't make more the higher it goes. You only make what you make at the top line. You're capped out. But it's a full profit. And what you make is whatever the points are. So this is a 20-point option. So you make 20 points. Options trade in hundreds. So 20 times 100 is 2,000. So if you sold this option, you would make $2,000 if this option expires at the top line or above. If the market goes nowhere, goes straight sideways, you would still make. Remember, you sold this for $20, and then but let me show you what it would look like on the close, because remember, the extrinsic disappears. It's time premium. It goes away. So it would just be worth whatever the in the money amount was, and if the market didn't move anywhere, theoretically. So the in the money amount was like, what, 10 points or something. So in any event, you would sell something. You would still be a profitable option trade. You would sell something for 20. And you would have to buy it back for 10. So that's fine. And that's option traders make a lot of money doing that. Not every trade's like a huge winner. Lots of times they just hit for singles. All right. But in any event, yes. Then if the market should go down, and if it goes down right to this bottom line, but no lower, it's just going to be break even. Okay. But then if it goes 1 cent under this bottom line, it's going to be, you're going to lose 1 cent. And it's going to go. The thing is, your downside isn't capped. It'll, you know, the further you go, the more you'll lose. But the upside, but so what you're really looking for is you're really looking for a day to go sideways or up. That's how you win about 2 times out of 3 when you sell options. You win on any day that goes up, win on any day that goes sideways, and you even win on days that go down, but not down too far. That's actually further than it looks. So that, and that adds up to about, I'm going to make a beginner's video soon, or I've made several, but anyway, yeah, if the market falls in the white zone underneath, then we lose money. The fund loses money. Yeah. But so the fund makes, so, but just think if you're doing this and market goes up, you make $2,000. Market goes sideways, you still make $1,000. Market goes down, but not too much, you break even. You don't lose anything. And then the market goes down a lot, then you actually lose money. But yeah, that's how selling options work. And that's why a lot of professionals sell options, because you can, a lot of professionals do it because it's something you can do every day and repeat and repeat and repeat. And that, well, that's the idea. That's the idea. But nothing's perfect. There's all kinds of, there's a lot of people that make a lot of money buying options too. And then there's, you know, it takes all different types. Anyway, yeah, the profit boxes are just a visual representation. All that is supposed to help you see. The reason I designed them is you can see how much you can look in a day how much the chart moves, how far these bars go. And most days go like this. And so any day that does something like this, you're going to make a profit. But you aren't going to make a profit on days when the market crashes. I mean, like I say, you make, when you're selling options, you make money 2 out of 3 times, but you definitely do not make money in down markets. But the counterpoint to that argument is nothing really makes money in down markets. That these things actually don't even lose as much money as like the SPY and the triple Qs in down markets, because the option selling brings in a little bit of money. anyway, that's what the buffer report's about. And I'm going to let you guys go. But the whole idea of the buffer report is to show you is also a visual representation. Let me try to get it on something. And in this case, but this, the red line and the blue line are visual representations of, one of them's the market as a whole, and one of them's these high yield funds, because we know, that's something we know. We know they aren't going to perform as good as the market on the upside. I mean, we know that. So when somebody puts a chart up of, you know, SPY I and then a chart of SPY and says SPY does so much better. Yeah, of course, we know that. SPY I pays five times the dividend of SPY. So it's not really a fair comparison. They're totally different investments. In any event, we'll have more we'll have more talks tomorrow. David, I thank you for tuning in. Dan's here. What's up, Dan? What is up, Dan? I'm trying to figure out how to freaking get over there. All right. Well, Dan, I appreciate it. David, I appreciate it as well. I appreciate all you guys for being here. Michael, I hope you're having a good night in the Philippines. But yes, I'm going to shoot this crash video. I wish I had slides so I could show you the slides. I do have them, but there, I guess I've closed that screen now. But it has like 10 slides. I said it's going to be quick. I say that always, but it'll probably be 30 minutes because I'll probably get talking. There'll be some other good stuff in that video, some more option talk. David, you might like the option talk in that video. I'm going to show here. Let me show you this one other thing, David. Oh, yeah. Well, that's okay. Well, so let me show you. Watch this. We're going to build a cash secured put. Okay. And we're going to do it in NDX because that's what triple QI trades. Okay. Okay, we're going to do the one-day option, so it's going to expire, you know, the end of the day tomorrow, the 3rd. See this right here? These are our strikes. This is at the money because it has this little triangle here. But anyway, we want to go a little bit out of the money, a few strikes out of the money. There's something in options called delta. That delta right there is 55. We want to sell the delta that's closest to 65. The 65 is the magic number. That delta is 58. So the higher you go in the money, the higher the numbers get on the delta. 61. Delta also is the chance the option has, is the approximate chance the option has of finishing in the money. So at 65, this is an in the money option, and this is has a 65% chance of being a winner for the person that bought it, actually, or finishing in the money for the person that bought it. In any event, we're the person that sold it. This line right here is where the market is when we sold it, okay? This, so if the market goes up like 0.5% or more, we make max profit. That's for each contract, you make 14,900, okay? The market goes down, but no more than 0.3%, you break even, okay? If the market goes down, if the market goes down 0.5% on this side, you lose 4,000. The market goes up 0.5% on this side, you make 13,000. It's asymmetric. It's an uneven risk. I mean, you can also tell because the line is on the green. If the market doesn't move and you can still make money, that tells you that your trade has theta decay. The options are decaying, but they're decaying into your account. You could see right here, this is what the trade is worth now. And the lines here, watch, we'll zoom in. So the option decays as it gets closer to expiration. So right now, if the market were open, theoretically, it'd be about at a break even. But watch this, as time goes by, our little profits start to pile up. So this is in the morning. This is at 8 o'clock in the morning. Now at 8 o'clock in the morning, this trade will be worth $3,700 if they wanted to close it, but they won't. They'll just leave it on. they'll leave it on. And then it keeps getting time decay. And it goes from being worth $3,700, you know, at 8:30 to being worth $5,000. And then if the market goes up a little bit too, like 0.5%, and that happens lots of days, then this trade makes $14,000. Anyway, this is a great trade. And this is the short put, the cash secured put. That's the trade that these guys do every day. It's a simple trade. I mean, here's what people don't like about it. You know, if the market's down 7.1%, you lose $119,000 on each contract. And these guys, how many contracts did they sell? Let's look over here. What do they sell? I just did this, but they sold 141 contracts. Watch this. You guys might like this. So here's the stakes they're playing for. The market goes nowhere. These guys make $711,000. The market drifts up about 0.5%. They make $2 million, which is the whole cat. They capture the entire premium. If the market goes down, but not too far, they still do all right. But they even still make money, even when the market goes down 0.5%. You know, because 0.5% loss is a $17,000 loser, but 0.5% win is a $1.5 million or $1.8 million winner. That the bell curve goes right over the distribution is centered right on the dotted line, but it's so uneven that, you know, up 5% is worth way more than down 5%. So statistically, this trade is just a slam dunk layup. Trade doesn't mean it wins every day, but it's a high percentage. If you're an option trader, it's like hitting for singles. It's just a high percentage trade. And even maybe that helps people visualize it. That may have confused you more. But I have other demonstrations too. Just stick around and I show other demonstrations. Sometime I'll show you a back test, and I have other ways of demonstrating it. All right. So any event. But I appreciate you guys. Like I say, thank you, Dan. Thanks, David. Appreciate the questions, David, and last night's too. Brandon, you as well. Michael, everyone. All right, guys. I'll get busy on this crash video. Be looking for it. Let me know what you guys think. All right. See you later.